Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Markets. Just some tips on making the ultimate spare ribs. First, start with great spare ribs. These are baby back ribs, really good natural pork from Iowa. And I'm gonna cut them into individual ribs here. You don't have to. You can cut them in two rib segments, single rib segments. I like the single rib segments because I can season them all around. They get all nice and crusted. So then I'm gonna put them, line them up into a pan, and I finish them up with this Claude's brisket marinade. This stuff's great. It's got a nice smoky flavor, especially nice if you're using a gas grill. So I pour this on top of there, I cover them with foil, I put them in the oven and roast them for about an hour, hour and a half. You cook them until they're nice and tender as you like. I don't want them falling off the bone. I like them a little bit chewy. They're done here. These could go back in the fridge for a couple of days. When it comes time to cook them, I'm gonna sprinkle them with seasoning, put them on the grill and get them all sizzling and finish them with sauce. And you've got the ultimate spare rib. We've got this recipe and all the recipes today at digincolorado.com. Stay right there. In a few minutes, we're gonna make country style green beans. Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Markets. Country style green beans, the best way you could ever make green beans. Starting out with some onions, sweet onions if you got them. Chop them up here. I try to make them about the same size as the green beans. They're gonna go into a pan with some bacon. I've got a nice applewood smoked bacon. We've got some beautiful bacon at Tony's. Look at this, look how lean that is. Isn't that beautiful? A superior product. Now, I normally would just use a smoked bacon, but we have a maple bacon. If you like maple, that would be fabulous. Extra maple in there, or even a peppered bacon, whatever you really like. Just make sure it's got a good smoky flavor to it. These two go into the pan. We're gonna let them saute and brown and soften. And while those saute, we're gonna get our green beans ready. We're gonna cut them into little pieces, cut the ends off, and get ready to go. This is looking good. It's getting nice and brown in here. I think we're ready to move on. We'll take some garlic, a few cloves of garlic, and just bruise them a little bit, just a little bump. All right, a little bit more. Add them to the pan along with our green beans. A couple pounds worth here. Mix that all together. Oh, I can smell the maple and the applewood and the sweetness of the onions. All right, this all goes together. I'm gonna use a little stock. I've used the Glace de Poulet Gold, really nice flavor without a lot of salt. You could use chicken stock, vegetable stock, whatever you like. You could just use water if you wanted to. Ham stock you could use if you wanted. So we get just about enough to fill it up there. I might just add a little bit more. We're gonna let this simmer. We're gonna let this simmer and cook down slow. What's gonna happen is it's gonna cook the moisture out of there and make a sauce. It's gonna be amazing. So this is gonna need about 15 minutes. And in the meantime, we're gonna work on our ribs. Okay, these ribs have been pre-cooked. I actually did them yesterday. It's nice, you could do it a day in advance, just save you time. Any way I can make a shortcut. Brush them up here, get that, so they're nice and moist all over. Then we're gonna sprinkle them. I've got my own seasoning rubs. This is our smoky Southern barbecue rub. We do a Texas rub, we do a mesquite rub, we do a Kansas City style rub. These get sprinkled all over the rib. You wanna coat it on all sides, really nice. So this has got all the seasonings, a little bit of smokiness, a little bit of sweetness in here. This is gonna glaze on the grill and work out really nice. I'm gonna put it on the grill about 5-10 minutes to get it hot and sizzling, and then add sauce to it. These will be on the grill for maybe 10 or 15 minutes and they'll be done. All right, this is about done. This cooked for about 20 minutes. I let it simmer for 20 minutes without a lid, and we reduced all the water that was in there. It's reduced away, and now there's just a little bit left at the bottom, kind of like a little bit of a sauce. There's probably a quarter cup of the juices left in the bottom, and it's a concentrated stock with the flavor of bacon and onion, and it's beautiful. Let me tell you, we're gonna go ahead and put this into a bowl. There we go. Save a little bit for later. All right, so we got that into the bowl. The country style green beans, just a beautiful dish, really easy, anybody can do this. You can taste it at this point, but usually the salt and everything, the seasoning is usually just about right. Maybe a little pepper I would add to it. And then our back ribs, we cook those slow. We put a little bit of the seasoning rub on here, and then we brown them and we finish it up with the sauce to glaze. Total cooking time was about 10 or 15 minutes on the grill. We've got it here, beautiful. Country style green beans and and baby back ribs. Let's dig in. You can get this recipe and all today's recipes at digincolorado.com.